Normally, you know, if you're in a crowd full of flute players, you want to play something with lots of fast notes. So I wonder who's first. I think, great. And what's your name?
Jennifer.
Bye.
Should I? I didn't know if I. Yeah.
Yeah, play the Kanto.
Okay.
Text edition of the piece also?
Not with me.
Not with you, but you have something you've been studying from? Mm-hmm. Okay, great. So that's always really, really important. So lots of great things. I love the vibrancy in your sound, the shimmering vibrato you have. It's very musical. Lots of really, really wonderful, wonderful things. Let's go back to the beginning here. And I bet all flute players in the room, we can all think back to how many different lessons we got on this opening. What do you do with that high D? Do you sit there and let the orchestra take over? Do you have a big crescendo? What do you do with your vibrato?
Mm-hmm.
Have you had this experience already? Okay. So, can you try once again and picking a spot just up there? Mm-hmm. And don't move. So it's like this stoic, like, presence you have, well, where you are, just in fact, letting the orchestra take over. Can you try once, just from the opening? There, you don't need the music, it's just a D. In fact, wait a minute, do you need the music for any of it?
Probably not.
Take it.
Take it, she says. The friend. This is your friend?
I don't know anymore.
So, how many times have you played this so many times, you don't need to be looking down. So, you're in that audition, if you play Mozart Concerti for auditions all the time. So, you can kind of imagine yourself. This is like flutist number 45. Right. Right. So, greet everyone. Hello. We've been sitting there for how long? How many Mozarts? How many of our Saturday afternoons?
I'm so sorry.
No! Don't be sorry. Right? But, what I'm trying to say is you know this so much better than you think you do. So try up there, somewhere over Kim's head. Give that D to Kim. When I was listening, I was like, I wonder if this just wasn't here, what it would be like. Because she's so musical, but she's caught.
Mm-hmm. You know,
yeah, she's hiding. So, you know, when the whole point is perhaps just like, you know, A, can you play the flute? Mm-hmm. Of course. B, you know, in these auditions, is, you know, I'm assuming we play these things for auditions when we're young, mm-hmm. a million times. Yeah. Probably more so than you play with Horror Story. Mm-hmm. So, fantastic. So, definitely that one. So instead of picking on minutia, do you feel just how many things changed?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
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 So, which, you know, that's what you. So I think you're gonna have to practice that way.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so that you don't get up, you know, to that moment and go.
Yeah.
Okay. So I bet the whole piece would, you know, have an entirely different feeling. So you just learned something pretty important about yourself, right? Oh, I play well from memory.
Yeah.
So then why don't you?
Scary.
Isn't it? Fortune favors the bold. So, good. Let's look at this first measure that you could, the flute comes in. It's your first, you know, impression. It's a really hard trill, right?
Mm-hmm.
Can you put this C key down just halfway? Try just trilling with it just down half the way first. Yeah, so, and what's going to want to happen is, you know, your finger's going to want to rock right off the key. But, see if you can keep it closer and not doing. Yeah! And now, yeah, and there's like a little bit, that moment where I want like the bow off the string, that magical place, where I hear that your bow is just always on. So that pickup, you know, relationship. Can you see if you can boom? All already better. I want to take that pickup home with me. Much better. And now the whole thing is a pickup to where?
Well,
or maybe even.
Well,
even
yeah.
Yeah, okay. Like that for. Yeah. Front of the first long D, right?
Mm-hmm.
So can it be simple because you have. So instead of.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
Give it a try. Do you really love the quality of your first D?
I need some help.
Try something else.
We were just looking at each other.
So, maybe perhaps more forward tongue. And a little bit of a burst of air from here, so that your bow has that.
Okay, well. Arabian.
Let's keep going.
Sorry.
With repeated notes like to be too close together. And they're even articulating. So really listen for the distance between those notes, making them as expressive. Start from. Good, and can the nutshell be a little bit quicker into the downbeat, so you're not like... Keep going. I want to take that pickup home with me. Just the sound. I want Michelle to go, oh, what a glorious pickup. Won't be easy. Yeah, so instead of picking it out of your flute playing, you have to pick it out of the air. You know, it's so easy, like, to be trapped. Mm-hmm. In this, be like, oh, this is for people, but... It's for people. Yeah, it's a character. It is someone. Good. And now, can the second note be louder than the first? Because it's like a it's like a pickup, right? Puppy. So it's a puppy. Ready? Puppy. Ready? Puppy. Yeah, crisp. Okay, have a look for here, yeah? Sure to subdivide 16th notes on the long. Can you sing what the orchestra's doing on the long whole note? So have that going on in your head, and that'll make coming off of the tie much easier. Ties are destroyers of all things rhythm, right? So okay, good for you. How does it feel to be playing right now?
It feels okay.
Mm-hmm. You know, it feels almost a little winded. Mm-hmm. To me.
Yeah.
You know, as you go, the breaths get higher and higher. Mm. Do you ever feel that way?
Yeah, like I'm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, you know, like, you could be really able to like explore the majesty, you know, in this music, mm-hmm. if it was like coming from a slightly more calm place, mm-hmm. in the respiratory vocabulary.
Yeah.
Can you play for me from here this 16th note passage, all slurred, once and slowly?
Like, do you want the dynamic too, or just
with your best sound? When in doubt, make it beautiful. Like a long tone? Just for a singing sound on every note. Full sound. Yeah, I bet your embouchure will relax into this a little bit if your air works a little bit harder. Good. Good. Left foot forward, right foot back. That'll give you some more space for your, you know, to breathe, mm-hmm. so you're not twisting yourself. There you go. Can you do it even slower? And even slower? Go for beauty in the sound, not just edge. Yeah, that's nice. Can you go even slower? Do you like it? Just listen for that sound on your first note. Do you love it? I wonder if in your practice room you let too many pitches go by without loving them. Sound-wise? Mm-hmm. Oh, can you sing that E for me? Yeah, so sing your flute. Don't blow your flute so much. Okay. Right? You know,
yeah.
Okay, we're gonna do this, right? You know?
Yeah.
Listen for those C sharps, keep going. Good, can you go even slower? Yeah, there you go. I think we have a speed demon.
Mm-hmm.
Are you a speed demon?
Yes.
So, you know, it's just a thing in our flute community that we, you know, you hear the best string players practice, and they're playing slowly for pitch and sound. And you're thinking, wow, he plays so well in tune. Why does he need to practice so slow? Right?
Yeah, right.
So there's such a pressure on us to play so many notes
mm-hmm.
that sometimes that's exactly what we do.
Mm-hmm.
So, but it'll really, I think in your playing right now, one way you could really get to the next level is to see just how slowly you could play it.
Mm-hmm.
Just to make sure that everything is your absolute best, because the absolute best of your playing is a really, really high level.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, the question is, how do you get everything
mm-hmm.
to that? I think it's going to take more patience
mm-hmm.
with yourself and more observation over are you determined?
Mm-hmm. I think so.
You strike me as determined, right? But perhaps this venture is going to be more about observation now. Can you be determined to observe from here now once?
Yes.
Your sound and pitch all slurred from here. Make sure every note has a singing quality. Hello. I will get this right so that he approves of tone and pitch. Right? So, un hey. Give it to un hey. She's right there. See, she's fine. Lovely. Dee da dee da da dee da da dee. Sing it in here. Listen for that C sharp. Do you like that C sharp?
Will I ever?
No. But you'll like it, you know, more and more.
Yeah.
So it's amazing, you know, in our pedagogy of how we set up young people. You know, we just say, oh, well, this is the fingering for C-sharp, and then you go, and then, like, 4 years later, someone comes around and says, yeah, no, that's C-sharp, quarter tone sharp. And you've been practicing C-sharp, quarter tone sharp, for years. So think about how many times you played C-sharp or eighth tone sharp.
I'm really good at it, by
now. Oh, really? So, you know, so you have to give yourself a break, you know, saying, if I played C-sharp, eighth tone sharp that many times, going to take probably many times of not, you know, and maybe even practicing slowly as a violinist would, you know, for pitch, because that's kind of what they're going to be listening for. Have you done that? So do you have any questions? then play that again for Unhe. And slow enough so that you can get your C sharp how you like.
Okay.
And then we'll stop.
I feel like I have a tendency to, like, dig way too deep. Like,
I'm glad that you diagnosed that.
Yeah.
I think it's too fast.
Yeah.
Tempo, right?
Yeah.
So I think if you're practicing now, if you go home and say, my practicing is going to be all about what I can hear mm-hmm. instead of all what I know what to do already. Mm-hmm. Great job.
Thank you. Yeah.
You're Dale?
Yes.
Great.
Thank you.
That was crunchy, sorry.
Well, this piece is so much harder than it looks.
It's terrifying. It's the first time I've played it in front of people.
Congratulations. Yeah. Actually, really hard piece to stand up and play. You know, so much sound and pitch considerations that, you know, as soon as you get the slightest bit nervous, you know, it can be much more difficult to control. So, and I'm sure you learned right away, oh, no page turns in solo flute music. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's a big BJSU flute studio rule. So, but, you know, still lots of great things. So, how long have you been working on this?
On and off for about a month.
Great. What do you think, you know, as far as playing the flute goes, like, what's one or two things you really wish you could do better? Like, in this... Okay, so, yep, that's a big
minor
run.
Minor chromatic thirds, really quickly.
Okay. I see that you've written in your music, calm down, exclamation. I don't think it worked.
It was wishful thinking.
Yeah, sometimes I see something like that in my music and see opposite, yeah.
I love being able to be really, really loud, but when having to pull back, especially when really, really nervous, and it's doing the sputtering thing, I'm like, ooh, that's a sound, that's a choice. Not a good one, not a right one, but we're going to go with it.
So, dynamic control.
Yeah.
And, you know, where that, of course, intersects, obviously, with pitch. So, let's do that first, then. Okay. So... but, you know, really, like, I remember my first performance of this piece, and I was just like, you know, afterwards, too, so, you know, this piece is humbling.
It has to happen.
For everyone, so, yeah, it does. So, you know, I think if you had a greater variety of direction to your air... you know, dynamics would be so much easier to control, and then all of your phrasing ideas, you know, could really, and ideas for color could come to the fore much more without, you know, going sharp or flat. So if we look at this, you know, this, like, bouquet of D's at the beginning, I'm kind of blowing up straight up your nose. Can you try this D? Nice. Now can you give us a little bit of a moment to get into the atmosphere of this piece? You know, it's so easy to come up and do exactly what you practice at home. But give them a minute now. So now you have your D, you're going to blow it over Kim's head. So when you finally get there, but, you know, you have the time, you know. So, you know, you're thinking of that sunset or whatever you're thinking of. So now blow down more to your elbow. So, and then I think you'll actually be able to play forte. Because all of these D's land here. They have to land at this D. So basically this piece is D, 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 D. Oh! So, yeah, I think I saw a little bit and heard a little bit more direction there. So for some reason, everyone plays this piece with like five fermatas. In this first line. But, you know, subdivide. Do you have a pencil?
Oh, my, thank you.
So, start subdivide. There's a problem here with this tie, right? So start subdividing to the left of the problem. The ties are generally too long or too short.
Okay.
Which one?
Oh, too short, sorry.
No, they're too long!
Oh.
So, D. D. Ding dun 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 dun. Go louder, and Motown! Singing! Maybe a little proud from here, even. So the air is resonating inside your lungs, is we can get to that D and go... I will be loud, I will will you! To be loud! If you open your mouth, this way. The air will go which direction?
Down.
Yeah! And that way you can have more air without going. Sorry. Yeah, just from here. Yeah. So, and then, what are you going to subdivide here? You need far more subdivision, my friend. Music is in the subdivision. The pianist taught me that, not a flute player. Because every tie adds almost an eighth note otherwise. So 2-4 becomes 2.54 in a piece by Shocky Bear. 2.54, that's in my Takemitsu. So but you finally got there! You got to B flat major! Yes. Oh, big rolling chord. So, and it's still forte too, right?
Yes.
Right.
I ran out of breath.
So there's all these musical. Mama's like, no, don't worry, that's what practice is for. You'll subdivide and you'll steal some subdivisions for your breath. So, because otherwise you'll have 2.54 measures all over the place. So for example, mark out, you steal that tie. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you just mark a big old breath right on top of it. So, that way you don't play the tie and then breathe. And then take an extra eighth, right? So, oh, and you see that dot? Steal it. So, because how many rests are on the first page?
None.
Oh. Yeah. So, you know, humbling, right? To say the least, right? So, because I think if you were to record yourself and to conduct back, how many times have you done that and been horrified, Michelle? Nanny. Me too. So, you'd really see, oh wow, I'm taking all sorts of time everywhere. And if you're recording this piece for a flute competition, likely what are they doing? To every, you know, all 73 Jockey Bear PS recordings.
Yeah, just listening. And
it makes it so much easier to just be like, oh, not this one. You know, it's 1 o'clock in the morning. You know, you have to be there teaching at 9. You already listen to people play the flute all day. You're, you know, judging these competitions, and then, you know, you're like... Along with it, right? You're not going to say, that one! So, it'll be helped so much, you know, you see how I... stole his dot there with a breath. So I stole his tie. So, and that way you'll more likely to get to B flat major. You've got the tempo to get there. And you know, you'll be playing, you know, many less bars.
Yes.
Because they'll be shorter. So there's more chance you'll make it. So can you try from D da da D da D? Can I hear character in your slurs? That's a character. That's slur. Yeah. It doesn't mean just tongue here and not again till there. That's a character. give us a character. Make us go, oh, who's that? Is a what note on the flute?
Flat.
Oh, as a pancake, right? Pancake in Toledo. So you know, you gotta blow far more up. Big time. Every single D flat. So you'll have, because otherwise you'll have, there's five notes of a pickup. You'll have flat, 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 sharp, sharp, flat, flat, sharp. In that very order of the pitch tendencies of those notes. Humbling indeed. So, you know, kind of like I said, like, you know, the dynamic control to play it like the seamless dynamic. Wouldn't it just be so simple? But we have sharp, flat, sharp, flat, sharp, flat, sharp. Tendency, right? So it just means you have to bend it a little bit slowly. Dee dum bum 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 bing. So up to my hand for that D flat. Dee da dee summertime. Dee dum dee. Dee da da dee da dee. So I stop all the time, right? Because I don't have perfect pitch, so I've got to be like, okay, that's a tough interval right there. Right? Let's hear like something else I know, you know? Okay. And then E flat slightly higher. Where's the subdivision, my friend? So this Thomas Neifinger, you know, had all of his students play articulate the subdivisions. I think that would just help you find the simplicity in this a great deal, because you want, yes, you need rubato, but if it's not based on the subdivision, you no longer have rubato. You have thievery. A pianist taught me that. So govern your beautiful sense of rubato with what's there, with the subdivision. Otherwise, you're going to have people on juries going, they've done it to me. So I'll save you that pain. Uh-oh, too many. But hey, that is like, isn't that, won't that be helpful?
Yeah.
So, and then you can phrase, you know, you can hear exactly where you are rhythmically, like in the phrase, like just how long you have to make this and that, how long you have to make a color change, how long, you know, versus your brain constantly guessing as to where this has to be, mm-hmm. Right? So... So you can make your subdivisions really, really musical. And then all of a sudden you're up there playing. It constantly going. So I think that's just a matter of thinking about this and practicing this differently.
Okay.
Yeah. Great. Awesome playing.
Thank you.
We have Justine. We were just having a chat about this piece, that it's important to study from both versions. This early one, spatial notation, but also the that imagine it too loose with his with his written indications, right? So when you see it and you see the rhythms, how hard they are, you wish you hadn't seen it. But it's really, really helpful because you can kind of see an entirely different rhythm of character in the rhythms. Mm-hmm. Cool. How much of this did you want to play?
We'll see where I start messing up. Maybe like page 3. Somewhere like that.
What a,
around there.
So like. Or,
yeah, maybe like around there.
Are you going to have a... Oh no, this is your page 3.
No.
Are you going to have a page turn 2?
This is the last page.
Okay. Okay. Where do you want to step?
Yeah, maybe like there.
Yeah, maybe... Okay.
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 We'll see. Thank you.
things, and this peace will be with you for forever. Right? So, how long have you been working on this?
I don't know. Off and on.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah,
like,
great.
A couple weeks here, and then like a couple months off, and then a couple weeks there, and then, yeah.
Well, you've got, you know, a lot of, like, joie de vivre in your playing, lots of, like, you know, great characters, and I think, you know, I have some ideas, like, you know, the flute playing, how you can maybe even be more successful and bring them out even more. So, you know, if all cruelties, of course, it starts, you know, low A, you know, SFFZ with a carrot.
Craft it.
Every single one. No, not every single one. So, you know, in order, you know, let's just talk this through for a second. So in order for this to be really, really loud, in order for this to be pungent and short, do you need a lot of air, a small amount of air, fast air, super fast air, super slow air? What do you need? All at once.
Oh. Wait, on that
say
one
that
note?
A, yeah.
Oh. Fast?
Yeah. So, but what? But then how do you get the high, you know, the highest A on the flute then? That's where you get really, really faster. The lower you go on the flute, the slower the air you need. But to get a really big, large dynamic, a forte, that means you need a lot of it. Mm. Mm. So, can you play your A for me once?
Loud.
When in doubt, play beautifully. Great. So, let's think about, you know, your aperture. Now we're going to go for forte. So to get a lot of air to go through the flute, but not so fast that it cracks up, do you need a bigger aperture or a smaller one? Better one. Because if you think about that watering hose, you know, if you had one pressure from the spigot, if you put your hand, your thumb over it, it's the same amount of water, but it goes faster. So right now, your aperture is too small, I think. So, which is great, because how many of us have taught younger folks and spent, you know, weeks and months on, now we're gonna need to get that aperture smaller, because it's the size of a dime. So it's actually, you know, in your early years of flute playing, you know, a huge success to have a small aperture, and now someone comes along and says, so now you're going to need, you know, different, you know, sizes of aperture. Try the A above it. Can you see how big my aperture is? Yes, left foot forward, right foot back. Yes, use your legs now. Use your entire thigh grabbing hold inwards in a circular motion towards the bone. Mm-hmm. And can you feel that, you know, all throughout mm-hmm. your legs mm-hmm. now? So that pressure you need, and then you can open here and sing from there. Yeah. Nice. And now the lower one. Great. Now tongue. There you go. Well, why did it crack up? Because the air was too much, too fast, too...
I don't know.
It's too fast.
Okay.
Yeah. So this is like, you know, a hallmark of what I, you know, do at BJCY, you know, Flute 101 quiz. Mm. Why is this happening? Can you diagnose? You know, why does that mean? And I think if you can diagnose all of these things, because you know, I think your level of flute playing would skyrocket, and then like all of these great musical things you know in your heart you can do are going to, like,
work.
Oh, yeah. But this piece is, you know, even just the first note, frightening, right?
Yeah.
So, see now, you know, so if articulating at this dynamic is going to be much more difficult, why? Because the tongue makes the air go faster, making there be even more chance you might crack. So don't do the hardest version first. So it's amazing, you know, how we go, as musicians, go through all of our training, you know, and with the one focus of play what's on the score. But here is a score that's too hard to just take it out and play it. Right?
Yep.
Have you noticed that? Paul has. It's too hard to just take it out and play it. You're going to have to, like, spend more time than you've ever imagined in your whole world before creating exercises of how, figuring out yourself how to do every single thing in here. Every single one. So let's do a couple of those. So imagine there's no rhythm here, and we're going to take all of these eighth notes, you know, grace notes or otherwise, just as dee-da-dee-dee-da-bee-dum-bum, and a little bit slower. Dee-dum-bee. So we want your biggest, loudest sound, because it's fortissimo, without the tongue first. No tongue, all slurred.
Oh.
When you sing, so make, there you go. Yeah, when you come up in register, come down your body. So grab all your quads to the bone. There you go. Singing, yeah, do, wom. Keep going. Mezzo forte now. Oh, sorry. And then fortissimo, diminuendo, mezzo forte. There you go, do that again. So at home you're going to do this like 70 times. Beautiful sound. Yeah, it's so much more sound. Use your knees, Justine. Yes, you can get your lower back into it so your mouth doesn't have to work quite so hard. That's so good. Do it again. Good. So in order to get... So it's attempting to roll in for the lower register, right?
Use my knees.
And they're there. Ever met a flutist that was like, oh, my knees hurt so bad after practicing?
Is that what happens?
My legs. My ankles hurt so bad. No, it's, we always hurt ourselves from here up, right? And usually because we're not using down low enough. That one's piano, right? Make Kim go. Yeah, there you go. So you're gonna have. Who's there? Okay, so now add tongue. Ti ta ta ti ta ti tongue. See what happens. Interesting. It's so much more successful when mouth comes down, when your corners come down and your mouth open. So, but as you're wanting that forte, it's going to go, right? Like this, right here. Oh, yes. Michelle knows all about that. So, it's not about applying pressure here, right? It's about space here. If we can do one thing, let's get the best sound you've ever made on that hive shark today.
Okay.
So, can you, you know, I'm hearing so much of your sound come from here as you press for louder. So, I have a vibrato exercise for you to move here. Can it be horrible like that once? Just moving here, completely relaxed there. Use your knees. Good, you don't need any movement here now. Let your shoulders move. As if you're a part of the room, not a flute player. Move in the room. This is my shark. Because as soon as you're... Long tones. Move here. Don't get locked. Not here, though.
Again.
Yeah. Good. Yeah. Move there. Lovely. So now a harmonic. But my mouth, the back of my tongue is coming down like that, and my soft palate's coming up like that to create this big, big space. Oh. Yeah, good for you. Now this harmonic. Yes, left foot forward, right foot back, so that your ribs are in line with your shoulders are in line with your hips.
Like a yoga pose.
You don't need to be that far apart with your feet, but yeah. So you want your hips in line with your shoulders, otherwise the rib cage can't open. There we go, yeah. So now, hips and shoulders in motion so they're not locked. Nice! Now this next harmonic. Now the normal fingering. Sometimes my tongue comes on top of my lower teeth. Try that. Again. Nice. So, yeah, doesn't need to be. What if, you know, just relaxed here. Yeah. Give us your foot joint. Yeah. Good. Now try it in fives. Vibrato. Lovely. Okay. So now, dee da dee bit da ba dee da. So this is what her practicing could look like. I'm gonna get just the best F sharp. Because someone else is out there getting their best F sharp. That's for sure. Start from, so dee da dee bit da. Here. Yeah! Work harder here. Wow! Yeah! Yeah, Justine! Fortissimo, diminuendo. There you go. That's practicing.
Yeah.
How long did it just take us to do just that one line? So that's what I want you to do at home. With all the lines. And then I think you'll go into your next lesson. You'll be like, what do Who are you? And what did you do with Justine?
Yeah. Let me tell you a secret.
So,
I haven't had a lesson in like 2 years.
Okay. So, well, even better, you know, we're here working, you know, a little bit, so, you know, to renew how you practice.
Yeah.
Because if you want to get, you know, monumentally better, chances are you have to do something monumentally different. Mm-hmm. Good for you. That's a great tip. Yeah. Okay.
Oh,
we're done.
Missed it. Oh, we're done.
We have Simona, did I say that? So do you have your whole first flute part?
The
your whole first flute part?
Yes.
You do? Good. Are you going to play the solo?
Yeah, just the solo. Is that okay?
Of course.
Is it okay if I record? Just so much.
Go for it. Yeah.
Thanks.
And where are you from?
Bulgaria. I don't need the music.
You recorded this, right?
Yeah.
Let's listen.
Oh no. That's only for me and me. Well,
we've all heard it already. I think, you know, the best way I can help you to practice, you know, is if we hear some things together.
Okay.
So, because what in your practice room can you actually fix and change? The things you can hear, the things you can identify yourself. So I think the best thing we can practice now is how to identify some things.
Okay.
So. Oh yes. Do you know what's happening rhythmically in the accompaniment?
Yeah.
Good.
One, two.
So I would love for you to say that and conduct along with your own accord. Because this is, when you take an audition for a summer festival or grad school or professional orchestra, they're going to be conducting, tapping, just like Unhe was, just like Jeff was when he heard a rubato that didn't make sense to him, right? So... I'll try to conduct back. It's the most valuable thing you can do. Okay, so enough. That's enough, right? So, and that's okay. You know, it's totally, you know, oh, I get embarrassed for myself recording myself and listening back excerpts like this. Don't you, Inpe? Yeah. You're like, you know, because it's impossible to really judge, like, you know, when you have a flute glued to your face, sometimes what actually really happened. Yeah. So, you know, I'll say to my students at BGSU, it's like, if you were taking a history test where you knew, you were given an answer key to like 60% of the answers on the history test, you would study those answers like wildfire. But then you're walking into the audition room where 60% of the answers are, can they conduct along with y'all? And you didn't look at the answer key, right? So I feel for you. Because I was that guy. How's this? Right? You like my colors? And then wondering why I didn't get into Festival B. You know? So, but it, I think it's going to be really, 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 really helpful if, because you're a beautiful flute player. Oh my goodness. So, just to give yourself that feedback.
My teacher calls it Simona's rhythm. What?
Oh, my rhythm.
Well, let's get, try to, you know.
Her own, like, codified rhythm.
We'll try to get closer to Ravel's rhythm. You know, because we can. So, you know, you can practice. And play along while you're walking through.
Ooh, I love that.
Yeah, I'm not going to demonstrate that. But if, when you can do that, you know, there's going to be a sense of like internalizing that. So, did you want to try that at home? Oh, you want to try that now? Okay, great. Give it a try.
Okay.
One, two.
Oh, one more.
Yeah, but hey, that's a great first try, right? Really great first try. So that's really promising, you know, of what, you know, the final result is going to be. So you're going to need friends to conduct you. You know, to, you know, to test the rhythm. You're going to conduct back your recording. You know, I would say, you know, the first two lines are up to 177 would be enough of a sample.
Yeah.
I think. What do you think, Michelle? Like 87 times before she plays this for anyone else?
With the step?
With the steps, without the steps. You can record it with the metronome. Why not? Yeah. So you can record it, have your metronome, and say, now I'm going to put the metronome on to match my recording. It might take a measure. But then you'll see. Right?
Yeah.
Because sometimes our own clapback
can be a little biased. Okay, so there's a bunch of ways you can work on it.
Yeah.
The nine finger exercise. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. So that you're feeling all the subdivisions. Can you play? Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
So much. So the first thing, it sounds like the first thing you did in your preparation for this excerpt was, oh, the colors. Oh, the lines. Oh, the phrasing. I love it. So perhaps now the first thing you need to, you need to say, okay, the first thing I need to do is I'm going to sit at the table without my flute. No flute. The flute is the destroyer of all things rhythm, right? It really is. So, yeah, I know, right? So, you know, sitting at the table, you know, working at the table, you know, my lesson with Sophie Charrier in Paris, she was like, you need to do work at the table. No flute. So here, making a count for every single 16th note. And then I think you could get into just about like anything you wanted to, because there's such a beautiful sound and so musical.
Thank you.
Yeah! So, you know, figuring out exactly, just mathematically,
okay,
what's going on, tapping it all out with the metronome,
okay,
because this is such a distraction.
It is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
To the actual rhythm. I think I would have had far more acceptance letters to festivals and stuff.
Yeah.
If I'd like, really practice the rhythm.
Yeah. Okay. Good to know. So the subdivision is the number one thing, and then recording and putting the...
You already do so many things so beautifully, yeah.
No, to fix the rhythm.
That's number one. Yeah. Great. Play it again.
No subdivision.
Taking out the ties.
Okay.
So articulate all the ties. Ties are the destroyer of rhythm also. So you'll really get a sense. Da 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 da. Yes, exactly.
Okay.
It'll feel horrible at first.
Yeah.
Just musically. But that's okay. You know? Because if it isn't in rhythm, they won't pick you.
Yeah. But then when I practice on 126, on the 8th note,
mm-hmm,
and then...
There's rubato.
Yeah, that too. But then I start playing da-da-da-da. I just,
mm-hmm,
can't find the medium. So I still want the line, but with the,
mm-hmm,
beat. Without beating.
Do it for longer.
Okay.
You're
which
so
one?
Musical.
Which one? With the beat?
As,
or?
With the, as many beats as you possibly can. Practice that way for longer. I have no worries about you going into an audition and, you know, being musical. You're going to be very musical. Mm. Right?
Yeah.
So eventually, it just means you need to, you know, work on the rhythm longer.
Mm.
And then it will all sew together.
Okay.
So sometimes I think I've worked on the rhythm, but then I was like, oh, that was 2 days. But I worked so hard. And then I was, wait a minute. That was like a half an hour before lunch, actually. And on one day, and half an hour after dinner, but I worked on the rhythm so hard.
Okay.
You know.
Yeah.
So, but if we, you know, we just have to be logical, right? Because we learn these to convince a group of people that we can play in time and in tune.
Yeah.
Because that is the only thing that a group of five people, five different musicians, can actually agree on. Is that objective? So if you throw at those group of five people objective things that are plumb wrong, they are not going to pick you. So, okay. So, you know, in your actualization of the rhythm now, I hear far more, you know, if you were to think of this, like, even in 4/8, in 4/8, you know, just for the purposes of the math right now, and counting 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and I don't have enough of the ands. I want you to be feeling the ands, the inner part of the beat. And 4 and so like it's like this big beacon inside of you. Because if you have the inner part of each beat mapped out, in the trajectory of it, there's less chance you'll get to the next beat too late or too soon.
What if it's offbeat?
Oh yeah, do offbeats. Putting the metronome on offbeats is humbling. Play it with me snapping off beats.
Okay.
Oh, sorry. Right. So it's so hard, but like it'll, as it will take me and almost anyone, a number of tries.
Maybe without the skill, can you try?
Yeah, sure. Okay. And.
Oh, no. Hold on.
Yes, so you'll be able to test your ands if you record yourself and say back, and, so, and really see if you're feeling that inner part of the pulse. Because it's usually the inner part of the pulse. If the inner part of the pulse isn't solid, what will happen to your next beat? It will not be crisp.
Yeah. Whatever happens.
Yeah. Great.
I have a quick question. I know I'm jumping, but I really want to make. What do you recommend for dunking here? Where is the dunk supposed to be? Because I really want to don't separate it, but make a line. Because there is a slur, but sometimes I feel it just and it's separated.
Are you making a line with your air?
Am I? Yeah. Sometimes I just play just the B. To feel the beat.
Let's
just
hear that.
Do you like that? I mean, I just make up stuff to figure it out, but I'm asking.
Well, there is a crescendo there. And it doesn't start until here.
Okay.
So when in doubt, try what's there.
Okay.
So that's beautiful.
But it's not too separated, you think?
Well, no.
Oh, okay.
You know, and you know, that's the kind of thing you're probably gonna want two or three different ones in case, you know, you get asked. From behind the screen.
Oh. So how would be separated if they want it separated?
Let's see what yours sounds like.
I don't like that. Or
I don't think it's the biggest fish to fry right
okay.
now.
Okay.
So let's kind of continue from what about if I conduct or
okay.
tap in sixteenths?
Okay.
Keeping track of all of your 16th notes so you don't lose any. So I know we're pretty much out of time. So do you want to try
yeah.
just this opening once again? So
did you clap or no?
No clapping.
just imagine.
Yeah. Why you're gonna practice it now,
huh.
right? To have both be conductible and as musical as you were before.
So now it
feeling.
Wasn't musical, it was just adult.
Well, no, I thought it was still really musical. It was really musical. You're, I don't think it's possible you could play anything not musical.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. so I don't think you should worry about that. One final like trick that or thing that can be really, really helpful is if you can conduct while you're playing. Just this
Ooh.
Conducting pattern right here. You need to do it in chamber music anyways.
Uh-huh.
It's not a performance suggestion. but you'll see to yourself, you'll see all the time like... and it's actually really hard to play with your conductant. So that's one another way you might be able to internalize,
yeah.
you know, this pulse so that when you get onto the audition stage,
okay.
you know, you have something right there for you.
And then, was that soft enough, or was it...
I bet they might ask to hear that softer.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Beautiful playing.
Thank you.
And... Cat.
Yes.
How long have you been working on this fantasy?
Month.
Oh, great. Are you going to memorize it?
Yeah, for my recital.
Oh, you are?
Yeah.
You're going to play for some concerto competitions?
Maybe. Not on the horizon yet, but maybe.
Thank you. very impressive. So, I think you've learned how to play the flute so well with so little air.
Yeah.
Yeah. What are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, you're struggling for some air for a little bit during that.
Why do you think that is?
I feel like I rely on edge kind of projecting things rather than having enough air to support the dynamics and things that I want.
I think, you know, a read through Angelita Floyd has this book about Jeffrey Gilbert.
Oh, yeah.
The Gilbert Legacy.
Yeah, yeah.
Breathing, blowing, and breath control, this whole chapter. I think you should do all of the exercises in that chapter and read that chapter a couple times.
Okay.
And one of my teachers, Branson Wilson, has this article on breathing in the NFA pedagogy anthology.
Okay.
I think that research, you know, would be so, 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 so helpful.
Yeah.
But, you know, we're looking, staring down the top of this piece with orchestra. And the very first dynamic is an F. Ah! Right? So, and then we have technique coming off of ties. Right? So, lots of hard things. So, let's look at that first D. Can you play your forte D for me? So, you know, give it to the room instead of worrying about it. As soon as you worry about it, what happens to the amount of sound you get?
Probably goes down.
You don't even need a physical explanation.
Yeah.
That's just what's going to happen, right? So, I think if we can get you playing louder, we can have more of you. If you give more of yourself to us, it'll be great. As I go up and register, I come down in my body. There's an intensification downwards through my legs, yeah, to the ground. Yeah, no worry. Can you see it in your face? Mom, I'm here. Nice, that's better. Say, I'm here.
I'm here.
There you go. There you go. So.
That's all it took.
Maybe you can just do all of it already.
Maybe. That's sad.
No, maybe that would be wonderful.
Yeah.
So,
the first time.
You know, and the reason why I want you to read, you know, especially like, you know, the Gilbert, you know, it talks about how, you know, your breathing is only going to be as good as your blowing. So if we then think, okay, if she's playing, what's the next breath going to be like? Oh no, I'm so tense. Right? It can all cascade down the mountain. Right? So, you know, the blowing itself, you need confidence. So, because you need compression here, right? All the way up to the breath, because if you lose compression,
yeah,
everyone blow out all your air. All of it out. And then try to, take a big breath. Ow. You know, if you've lost that compression, if you've lost that confidence,
right,
we'll get down, you know, we'll get down to, like, you know, this first page, and all of a sudden you had no...
It left.
Yeah. So, you know... have that, like, intense confidence in your air. Can you try it? How long can you keep it now? Compression all the way to the breath. Keep going. That was so much better. I should do that much again. Yeah! I need all those notes. Yeah, da 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 da. There's extra in there. There you go. Low. Use your knees. Use your lower back. Yeah, keep going. Move with the music a little bit. It's a performance, not a statue. Go. Beautiful. Now just bow to my hand. Good. Now bow to my hand here. The second note isn't tongued too long. Can it be even a little bit more magical with your? Now you have room to come back. Can you open your mouth more? In my corner. Yeah, get your tongue on top of your lower teeth. There you go. Yeah. So, you know, in your next audition, they'll be like. And it is fortissimo.
That's true.
Yeah. Yeah, there's a lot going on there. So. Go for it. Get all those notes. So technique is 90%. Rhythm. Can you give that some finger rubato? But actually do that. No extra tonguings. Best to have intention, or you'll get there and you'll go, oh my gosh, it's this spot with the four fingers. No. Right. So actually do it with your finger. Finger about it. Yeah. Yeah, when it has that confidence in the rhythm, your fingers will like have something to go towards versus the, right?
Yeah.
Your fingers do that a lot.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Why? Yeah. You have the technique to do it. Well, you just proved to everyone in the room that you do.
That's it.
Well, making the rhythm musical, making it a part of, you know, the realization of it, a part of the style.
Yeah.
Right? So, and then I think everything will come together, could come together for you quicker than you're even imagining.
Okay.
Yeah. You know, amazing, you know, really good player works on making all of the rhythm musical and magically gets much better. No! Sometimes, you know, we think about, like, you know, getting better as this thing that's, like, out there. You know, improving our skills is this big thing out there that, you know, maybe someday some magical person will bestow upon us. And we'll have to do it exactly like they said. But what if it's actually just as plumb, simple as, like, good player works on making the rhythms correct and musical.
Yeah. Wouldn't that be something?
You know, thinks about, you know, how you actually create dynamics on the instrument. Like, how do you actually do it? How many of the people in this room have received comments back that just said, it needs more dynamics? You know, but, you know, working on actually how to do them. Okay. So, there's the 15 run. Notes, the run of 15 notes.
Yeah, there
is. It does say ad lib. You can go a little slower. Better to go a little slower.
Okay.
Right? So, I don't see any markings there. How are you dividing your 15 up?
Oh. Yeah, I'm just sort of, off you go. Then I land on the F. That's not the right answer. Yeah, I really, I haven't divided up.
Let's do it now. Groups of threes. Do da 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 da. Because technique is 90%. So if you have it, don't have the rhythm in a spot, you don't have it. You plum don't got it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So de da da de da. Yes, and this is your time to say, oh, it was you. It was you. Was this finger late? For example. Yes, and now can they stay closer to the keys? And as you go up in register, open your mouth so you don't go shuffle. Nice. And now at da 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 ha da da ha da da ha da da dum. So with a breath accent. Because then your fingers can really tell if they're lining up with the accent or not. Thus, improving your ability to hear, oh, that's where I was my fingers were a little late. That's where I was dragging and not having great rhythm, which would result in a crash. Nice. Now da 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 da. Do the second one. Yes, and now the third one. Dee da da ba da da da. Good. And now da 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 da. 2, 3, 4, 5. There. Yeah. Kimberly, 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 Kimberly here. Can you say that once? Kimberly, 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 Kimberly here. Kimberly, 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 Kimberly here.
Oh, you want
say
okay.
It? Yeah.
Kimberly, 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 Kimberly.
Yeah, the actual truth is Kimberly, 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 Kimberly here.
Okay. Oh my god. Okay.
There we go. Okay. That is crisp.
Okay.
So you, right now, you don't, if you're saying to yourself, my runs are like a mushy apple. Not that you have bad technique. Figure out a way to make the rhythm, part of the music.
Yeah.
Okay, now in fives. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. University, university, university here. University, university, university here. Good. And now 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And have some left over. Good. And now play da, D, or da 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 da. Too fast. But that's what this is for. Do it again from here. Da, dee. And then ab lib. Yeah, and those first notes of the 15, they can be just like you're waking up from a nap. Dee, 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 dee. There we go.
Okay.
So, I think that's really going to help all in the mirror so you can see.
Yeah.
I bet you'll see countless, inefficiencies.
Yeah.
And you'll really be able to, fix it by yourself. The more you can fix by yourself, the better you'll get.
Right.
Right.
Okay.
Cool. Any questions? Awesome. Lovely play.
Thanks.
so much, and thank you to Powell Flutes for, you know, Powell Flute Center.